What's up, noobs? Welcome back to the VGCI channel, and today I present to you my duck steaks deck recipes. So yes, I know this setup looks a bit weird because I don't have a professional and proper mic. I'm going to use my Logitech G Pro X wireless headset to actually record this video. And due to Singapore having its lockdown again because of the rise of COVID-19 cases, we are currently unable to host any meetups with any of my friends because they have limited the number of people that and gatherings that you could be actually held. So instead, I'm going to take on the opportunity to go on to online, or I would say remote card fighting, and doing more deck recipes. I'm trying to bring back the deck recipes in which I haven't done in quite some time, especially for the new D-Series format. And I'll be probably featuring more streams on CFA, and yeah, we can probably have fun alongside then, as I'll be uploading my schedule really soon. That's one of the reasons why in the past 2 weeks my content has been delayed a lot as well, because of the rising cases in COVID-19. So hope you guys stay safe, stay at home, try not to interact with COVID-19 patients at all, and yeah, let's just jump right into it. So today I'll be featuring two of the most fireable decks in Dark States, as I know English BTO 1 is gonna come out very, very soon in English. If I'm not wrong, it's this coming Wednesday. So this is some sort of an idea as to what the deck builds into. I'm going to be using Bushiroad's deck log. So this is like an encyclopedia for all of Bushiroad games, as they feature all the cards. Unfortunately, it's currently only in Japanese, but even I, as not a fluent Japanese speaker nor writer nor understander, I can still navigate around the site. So I'll put links in the description below as the into the Bushiroad deck log, so that you can go check it out yourselves. And of course, you can see that the deck recipes are all under the code. So for this deck recipe right here, is the Final Rush deck recipe. It's AAR4, so just type it in the top right corner and you will be able to find my deck recipe right here. So let's just jump right into it. First, we have Final Rush before we're going on to Baromagnes. That's probably the two most meta builds we have in Dark States at the moment. So Final Rush, consisting of the trial decks, or start decks actually, in the D-Series. So first of all, we have the final boss. Of course, we have Bruce. Yes, this is Diablo's Eden, or Diablo's boss Bruce, whatever. So simple skill, I'll probably put it in the video. You can read it by yourself. Start off your right face, you're in Final Rush, and then if this unit is in Final Rush, when you attack, so plus 5, stand 2 of your rearguards in front row. So it's a really good card. I think out of all the decks in BTO1, probably Final Rush and Baromagnes, along with Bastion, is probably one of the more meta ones, because of its consistency. But of course, there are flaws in Final Rush, in which your early game and before you get into the Final Rush stage, basically your deck sucks dick. So I run cards to prevent you from sucking in the early game and try to mitigate some of the damage before you actually get into your full force Final Rush phase. Moving on, we have the trial deck card. This card right here, I'm not too sure of its name actually. It's Time Fissuring Fist Colossus. Yes, trying to use the English translation. So yeah, skill basically, on place you soul charge 1. If you're in Final Rush, you may count plus 1 and give this unit plus 15k. So if you do persona right on the turn that you have the Final Rush, it's actually a 38k beat stick. It's a 30k guard twice because of Bruce skill. You're probably gonna stand this using Bruce. So it's a really good finisher. Recommend you run at least 2 copies. I think 3 is fine. 4 might be a little bit excessive because it's a great 3. Of course, you are running another great 3 in the deck, which we'll get to later. So with more great 3s, we need less shield value. And if you know, Final Rush is a very late game deck, as you need to get into your Final Rush phase, which is basically a turn 4 phase. So before then, you're actually just a sitting duck. So it's good to run cards like a grade 1, grade 2, which offers more shield value rather than grade 3. Moving on to Majori, I don't know the full name actually, and I don't really care. It's more because of the skill. The skill is really, really strong. So once per turn, when this unit attacks, if you're in the Final Rush, put one of your other rear guards into your soul, draw 1, so charge 1, and this unit gains 10k at the end of turn. So it's really good, especially where you get a free, not free, I would say a net draw one, surcharge one, and power. So it gives you all the three things that you actually want: draw, surcharge one, and power. But problem is, of course, you need to be in a final rush phase, and that's when this card really shines, because it's a base itself is 23k attacker persona, right? It's 33k, so it makes really, really good magic numbers against your opponent. So it's 25k guard. And one of the alternatives is this finisher as well. Problem with this deck is it kind of soul charges really, really fast and runs out of deck really fast. So ideally, you want to end your opponent ASAP. So you can see that I run four Marjorie and four of the Colossus just as the finishing tools. So as for right decks, you can see that one-off, that specific one-off in this deck recipe right here, which is the Diablo's Boy's right chain, the grade one and grade two. So this one and this one. Skill for the grade one is very simple. If you ride over this starter right here, you call it the rear guard circle, you surcharge one, and then if you're in final rush, this unit gains +5k, but it doesn't really matter, you just want it for the right chain. As for the grade two, it's pretty simple as well. If you roll on top of the grade one that I just mentioned earlier, put one rear guard into your soul. Basically, you ideally want to put your starter. That's one of the reasons why the grade one calls it out. Put one rear guard into your soul, you draw one card, so it's 3+1 for you. And if you're in final rush, it gains +5k or so. So it doesn't really matter. More of the like trial deck, a start deck, sorry. The start deck is for you to have at least one copy of this and your right deck, and that's basically it. So moving on to the other grade two that we run, we have this, which is the triple rare. I don't think it's particularly great, but I don't think it's particularly bad as well. So first skill continuous, if you're in front of us, this unit gains +5k, and when it stands by the effect of your card, it gains +1 crit. So on the second time where it stands due to Bruce's skill, because of Bruce's skill, it stands two rear guards in front row, it gains crit +1. It doesn't really get power by itself because it's pretty small. It's a 15k attacker. If persona right is 25k, and yeah, sure you get the pressure of the crit, but most of the time you either want Colossus or Marjorie as your two front rows because they offer much more power and skills in compared to this grade two right here. Second skill, I think it's pretty good for his early game. I guess if your opponent really wants the damage, it's on hit. You count plus one, choose one opponent's rear guards and retire it. So yeah, that's basically it. And you must attack the vanguard if I'm not wrong. So I think it's fine to run limited copies of this. You don't really have to run four, you can cut it down. But ideally, if you have nothing else to run in a deck in which I don't feel that there are other cards better, you can just run this as an alternative. Moving on to the start deck, we have this card right here. Because of the new implementation of the D series, where 15k shields do sorry, 10k shields do not exist anymore because all the great ones have re been reduced to 5k shields. This is a good alternative in the early game for a final rush deck because you really have a dog shit early game, so this helps to get through the early game before you get to your turn 4 turn. So on place Guardian Circle, count plus one, this unit gains +5k shield. And this deck doesn't really use count plus at all. It is zero count plus actually. If you look at all the skills, it's mostly just either soul blast or soul charge. Other than this and the Colossus, the rest of the deck doesn't use count plus. So this is a really good alternative if you want to run it. I recommend you do run it at least two to three copies, depending. The start deck provides three copies, but yeah, you can technically cut down the grade two I just said earlier for another copy of this guy. So yes, 10k shield, I think it's pretty good. And the wording states that, you know, when it's on place on the Guardian Circle, so if you intercept with it while this guy's on the field, you still get the effect of calm lasting one, and this unit gains +5k shield at the end of the battle. So really good. Moving on to the trial deck, the other one, the start deck, sorry. This acts as the soul charger for the deck because you always need to have a consistent 5 soul in order for you to activate boost skill on your final rush turn. So rear guard, when it attacks or when you boost, if your vanguard is bruised, you soul charge one. If you are in final rush, you soul charge another one. So two copies, I think it's fine. You can bump up to three, but I don't recommend you running more than three copies. Maximum is three. This is the right deck grade one. Oh, the other world grade one that we run, it's very good early game as well. So I'm not too sure of the name, but on place rear guard, you soul charge one, and then the other skill is X once per turn, you soul blast three, draw a card. So Yes, you can run cards in the early game if you can to actually build up your soul and immediately use this skill to not lose card advantage and gain card hand size to prepare for either guarding or for your final rush turn. But other than that, yeah, this is a very good alternative in the sense that it basically nets its own cost. So it's instead of soul blasting 3, it's actually soul blasting 2 because of its first skill where on place rear guard is soul charges 1. So if you think about it, soul plus 2 draw 1 card, which I think is really good. So yes, you do run 4 of it. Last but not least, I know this card's name for some reason is Protobalt Dragon. So yes, it's the card exchanger. It's pretty strong. I like it in the D series. I wish it came out in V series, but that might be a little bit strong. So skill. If I'm in Final Rush and when this unit attacks or boosts, Karma Blast 1, put one of your other rear guards into your soul, take one card from your soul back to hand. So it's basically an exchanger for one rear guard for one card in your soul. So example, if you accidentally soul charge your over trigger into your soul and you want to get it back because it is a big ass 50k shield, Protobalt Dragon is always here. Problem is, of course, most of these cards in this deck is all Final Rush, so you have to wait for your turn for turn in order for you to use it. But this is quite an important card, especially to dig out your pieces. Like example, you want a Persona 9 Nixon, you can always dig out a Bruce that is in your soul. You can dig out a Majori, Colossus Dragon, or any other card that you deem useful, especially sometimes you want to dig out your Perfect Guards, your Sentinels. So this card is really good and it's necessary in the deck. So for Perfect Guards, I'm pretty sure it's necessary in almost all the decks. Skill, I think it's quite a good skill compared to the old one where you have to discard a card. I mean, this Perfect Guard still discards a card, but if you are less than two of if you have two or less hand size, you don't really have to discard. You don't have to discard a card. So that's the difference between the old Sentinel and the new Sentinel. Starter, and then for triggers, I think it's pretty simple. It's flexible, as I said before. Triggers you can run where the frick you want. I run 7 crits, 1 over trigger, 4 draws, 4 heals. So it's pretty simple, and you don't really have to think too much about it. Some people like to run fronts instead of crits because you get more extra power with standing rear guards, but I think. To me, checking crits in the early game is more important than checking fronts in the early game because, as I said before, this deck runs on a really slow engine where you need to have a turn 4 in order for all of your cards to be activated, or most of your cards to be activated. So, running fronts in the early game and checking in them really doesn't have a good or much impact on the game at all. So, yeah, so that's basically it. You can go check out this deck recipe. The code is at the top right corner of your screen, AAR4 on the Bushiroad deck log website. So yes, moving on to Baromagnes. So Baromagnes, same thing. The code is right here, CUHY, and we're just gonna jump right into it. So Baromagnes, in comparison to Final Rush, I think it's a little bit faster, but of course you need to hit the condition of your full 15 soul in order for you to get the maximum effects. So skill. We're just gonna jump right into the grid tree, the main boss card of the deck, Baromagnes. When it enters Karma Blast 1, you activate all the effects according to the number of cards you have in your soul. So 5 or more, you draw 1. 10 or more, this unit gains 10k1 crit. And 15 or more, shove all rear guards, including yours and your opponent's, into their soul. Choose 2 cards from your soul, call it the rear guard, and they both plus 10k until the end of the turn. So it's quite simple, and at the same time, it's quite very intuitive in my sense that we should actually create this card. It's something to. It reminds me a little bit of like what No Life King in V series, but instead, you know, it counts the number of cards in the soul right now. And yeah, I think it's really fun. I actually love playing this deck compared to Final Rush. Final Rush, yes, you get the explosive turn 4, but Baromagnes is more of consistency. And at the same time, if you pull off 15 soul on your first ride into Baromagnes, it's completely insane. But of course, at the same time, if you pull off your 15 soul, your hand size is probably going to be dog shit. So, yeah. Even though this nets you back a card, yeah, it gives you back a card. You have to rely on some units in order for you to get back your hand size and prepare for to guard your opponent next turn. Anyways, so yes, this Baromagnes skill. Moving on to the upgrade tree, run Baromagnes support. I'm not too sure what's this guy's name, but whatever. Either way, we run it for the skill only. The first skill is insanely strong. On plays rear guard circle, if your vanguard is Baromagnes soul charge 2, that's insanely good. That's like on play soul charge 2. No such thing in like in like V series. I don't think there's a card in V series that is so free where you're just on play soul charge 2 with a second ability, which is X. You have 10 or more, so count plus 2. Your whole front row gains plus 5k until end of the turn. So yes, it's quite interesting to see that they actually come up with this kind of card, and it's a rare some more, with so free cost as to on play soul charge 2. So yes, it's a really good card. I recommend you run 4 because of course on your grade 3 turn you want to try to build up as much soul as possible. On your first grade 3 right, the ideal soul you want to actually get is at least 10, so you get the 10k1 crit pressure. But of course, if you're able to go 15, just go 15, you know, why not? You're trying to end your opponent ASAP already, so yeah, just go 15 for all I care. So yes, this card is really good, and if you actually note the second skill, it's actually not hard once per turn, so you can actually use it more than once if you really have the counter blast. But of course, that's pretty stupid, unless it's like your final turn or whatever, and you have, for some reason, you have 5 open face up counter blast, so yeah, then go ahead, go for it. Moving on to the right deck. So the right deck actually consists of Baromagnes, of course. We have this guy right here, I'm not too sure what's his name, and then last but not least, we got the great one, this great one right here. So moving on to this electrocute boy, I'm not too sure. It's some electrocute Spartan or something, I'm not too sure of the name. So skill, when Baromagnes specifically rides over on this card, you put one card from hand to your soul, draw one, soul charge one. So yes, it nets the card, I guess, and it provides you one soul. But problem is, when you ride over this card with Baromagnes, you have to put one card from hand to soul first before you draw one, soul charge one. I wish it was worth it the other way around, where you draw one, put one card from hand to soul and soul charge one. That'd be way better. But other than that, I think this card's okay. And for the second skill, where it's pretty strong as well, it's like almost the same as the grade 3, but with a cost on place, regard circle, kind of last one, so charge 2. So yes, I've seen people run this card in actually Final Rush. So you get the pretty good early game with this card right here, where you know you soul blast 3, draw 1. It works, why not? But problem is, of course, you either have to cut some of the cards out, like you don't run this Diablo's boy at all because you think it's useless, which I think it's pretty much useless, to be honest. Yeah, but other than that, I think I would just prefer to stick with Final Rush cards, and Baromagnes cards. So yeah, this card is really strong, recommend run 4 of it. It's the main soul charger for this deck. Moving on, we have this thick lady right here. So it's a great 2. On hit, you soul charge 1. That's the skill of the first one here. The first skill is basically on regard circle, if this unit attacks, hit, soul charge 1. You can hit anything, and if the attack hits, you do have the soul charge 1. Take note, it's a mandatory soul charge 1. It doesn't say you may soul charge 1. So if the attack really actually goes through, you do have the soul charge 1. Second skill on regard circle, at the end of battle that this unit attacks, if you have 10 or more soul, you may shove this unit to your soul and counter charge 1. So yes, it's a really good counter charger. This deck uses counter blast, I would say, but there's the chance of you running out of counter blast, yes, every turn. So that's where Baromagnes actually comes in. The third skill of Baromagnes says when you have 50 or more cards in your soul, you may choose to cast your soul, call it out. So you can call this great 2 out from your soul and keep having at least one counter blast to play with. If not, the Baromagnes deck doesn't really work because Baromagnes requires counter blast. And if your damage stuck at 5 with 0 counter blast, you can just immediately scoop because, yeah, no counter blast. So yeah, this was one of the options that they gave for Baromagnes deck, which is really good. So soul chargers, at the same time counter chargers, so 4 off is a must. Same thing, this card in Final Rush must be played in Baromagnes because it's a form of soul charger. I think I got through the skill on place, soul charge 1, soul blast 3, draw a card, once per turn. So yeah, really good. Moving on, PG's 4 off of course, and then we'll move on to the last card, which is the right chain right here. So the right chain, on place, the first skill on place onto your Vanguard Circle, you soul charge 1. So simple, on place soul charge 1, run in your right deck once you know, if you are if you ride up from your grade 0 immediately switch to 1. Second skill, if you have 10 or more soul continuous during your turn, this unit gains plus 10k, so it's 18k beater. So ideally what you want to do on your Baromagnes turn when you're trying to end your opponent off, you ideally want to have two of these grade 1s in your soul, and then if you have 15 or more soul, you call two of these grade 1s out from your soul and they both plus 10k. So they're already 18k base, plus the skill of Baromagnes, they become 28k. With Persona Right, it's 38k. So yes, it's both 30k guard. Reasons why you're not running 4, because it doesn't soul charge. This deck requires you to have almost every card in this deck soul charges for you. And if you're running cards that do not soul charge in this deck, it delays your Baromagnes turn by quite a lot. So ideally you want to reach your 15 soul ASAP, but of course think about your hand size and how you're going to guard your opponent next turn is also a consideration. So ideally you wouldn't want to run 4, but if you really want to run 4, then you should go ahead. But you might have to cut out cards that soul charges in this deck for you. So that's basically hindering yourself, and I don't like it. So that's why, that's one of the reasons why I run 3 copies. Starter, I think it's fine. Triggers wise, I would like to run 8 crits, 3 draws, 1 over trigger, and 4 heals. So it's a little bit different, in which Final Rush I actually run 4 draws, and then in this deck I'd rather run 8 crits, 3 draws. So reasons why is because this deck focusing on ending your opponents more, and in the state where you actually get 15 soul, you're already soul charging almost half of your deck. It's basically almost like 1/3 of your deck already. So ideally you want to end your opponent ASAP before you actually deck out. And there are cases where the game drags on really long and you just immediately deck out due to the amount or sheer power of you soul charging. So you running more draw triggers, I'm scared that, you know, when you're getting down to your compressed deck already, your deck is really really compressed, you still have draw triggers in your deck, it really serves as a danger as you might deck out. So that's one of the reasons why I run 3 draws instead of 4 draws. I mean, it doesn't really make much of a difference, I would say, but you know, it's still something. You can technically cut out draws totally from this deck if you really want, but as I said before, triggers is very very flexible, and I think draw still plays an important part in this deck because we still need to draw into your pieces in order for you to soul charge. So yes, 3 draws I think is still okay. Moving on, after the triggers we actually have the order card, so we can run 3 different orders. So this order is quite interesting because it costs almost nothing, it just costs 1 card plus, and this requires you to have actually 10 or more soul to get all of the effects, which is really really simple in the Baromagnes deck. So it's a card plus 1 to play. When you play this card, you soul charge 1. If you have 5 or more, for each 5 cards in your soul, you choose one of your units and you gain plus 10k. So example, if you have 15 cards in your soul, you can choose one of your units and plus 30k, because it's for each 5 cards, choose one of your units plus 10k. So 5 times 3 is 15, so 10k power times 3 is 30k power. So you assign one unit 30k, especially if your opponent's on fire damage, they have to throw a perfect guard or hard guard for this attack, because it's just so bloody big. Especially if it's a late game where your Baromagnes is 20 or more soul already, it's plus 40k to one unit. So yeah, it's really really strong. And of course, the last but not least, the effect is if you have 10 or more cards in your soul, you draw 1. So I think it's really good. Count plus 1, soul charge 1, gives a shit ton of power to one of your units, and if you have 10 or more soul, draws a card, so it nets the card back, gives your soul charge, and gives an insane amount of power to one of your units. So I think 2 off is okay, you can run it as a 3 off if you really want, but as I said before, it's only good when you have 10 or more soul, and if you don't draw into your soul charging pieces, it really sucks. So it's a dead card in your hand if you don't draw into your soul charging pieces, and it's a really dead card in your hand in the early game, before your grade 3 of course. Moving on, we have Brother Souls. This card is in the start deck. Simple cost, you just discard this card and soul charge 2. So yes, I wish it was soul charge 3, but that would be pretty OP, because there's no card in VCs that is so free as to, you know, this retire itself and soul charge 2. Maybe there is actually, okay, but like, you know, as an order, I think it's fine. But of course, it would be better with soul charge 3. But I digress, because I want this deck to be OP, which is already is kind of OP. So yeah, 3 copies. In the start deck, I'm surprised they don't give you 4. They only give you 3. That's one of the reasons why I'm only running 3. I will run 4 if they give for, but yeah, I'm too money minded, you know, to buy another charger just to get this card at a fourth copy. So yeah, last but not least, we have this card in the set. It's quite simple, one off. It's like a tech for me. If you have five or more cards in your soul, choose one unit against plus 15k. So it's a blitz order where you get to play it on your opponent's turn instead of your turn. So yeah, blitz orders and normal orders are different, of course. So blitz orders can be only played when your opponent's attacking you, while normal orders can only be played during your turn. So yeah, it's a free 15k. It basically acts like a trigger, but not really a trigger. And in Baromagnes, where you have where it's really really easy to get far more, so this serves as a good shield for you in order to guard through your attacks. As I said before, if you actually do get your 15 soul at the start of your Grey-Chi turn, Grey-Chi, right, you have no shield value in a sense to protect you, because most of your cards will be on the field. And yeah, this serves as a good way to guard in the early game, I guess, if you really need to. Getting rushed down by Bastion or any other decks that have really good early game, this is a good 15k shield just for you. So yeah, thank you very much for watching. Hope you guys liked it. I don't think this video is that short, but ideally I would like it to be more in depth, as I said before. So hope you guys liked it. I'll be posting more deck recipes really soon, probably Dragon Empire next, and then I'll move on to all the other nations, because you know we only have 6 nations now and not 24 clans, so it's easier for me to do these deck recipes at a faster pace and more spread out, rather than doing 2 deck recipes of 2 different decks. I can just do 1 nation per video instead. So yeah, thank you very much, hope you guys liked it. I'll be posting more soon. I'll be streaming maybe on CFA next week when I have the time. So if you are free and if you are a viewer, you can come and battle my friends in a very friendly D-series format, I would say. So yeah, thank you very much, Dominators, for watching. Peace out.